Marketing agencies like yours are constantly looking for ways to do more for less. And there is now a growing cohort of cutting-edge tools to help your agency do this. AI-powered solutions have an increasing role to play in marketing agencies. We had an interesting conversation about the meeting of these two worlds, AI and marketing agencies, with Matthew Regini, the owner of Prospect Future.
Yeah, artificial intelligence, we use a little bit of Jasper AI in different things in terms of like content writing. So oftentimes we'll do ideation with AI tools first, and then from there we'll actually go in and kind of clean it up. We actually just did a social post on AI tools as well, but the ones that are really cool that I think are really going to change the name and the game in marketing is like the visual AI tools, like DALL-E is a really big one.
With these tools already being implemented at some marketing agencies, what are the key benefits of adopting this technology?
I think for creativity, they're absolutely beneficial. You can run into writer's block, you can run into designer's block, and having a tool that you can plug something into that outputs an idea that you may not have thought of, I think is incredibly valuable. The ability for DALL-E or these other image AI tools to create something unique that you can then purpose for your content is incredible. And it really cuts out a lot of the back and forth that agencies are having with clients where it's like, hey, we don't have any assets to utilize. And you can either go to like a stock asset library and look for images or whatever, or you can just plug in exactly what you're looking for into this, you know, AI tool, and then it literally pops out exactly or pretty darn close to what you need. And then you can kind of doctor it up or change it from there. There's also a lot of areas where it's like, if you're doing repetitive tasks over and over and over again, and you're not really adding a lot of creativity to that, you can use AI tools to get rid of, basically automate those repetitive tasks, and then you add in just one or two additional layers on top of it. So I think that is absolutely beneficial.
It's clear that these tools have a role to play in the marketing agency world, but for all of those benefits, what are the downsides?
In terms of reasons why I don't love AI is it definitely doesn't replace original copywriting or original design. Specifically on the writing side of things, you can tell when something's been AI written, and plenty of these AI tools argue against that and say, no, you can't tell. Like, we wrote this ad for you, or we wrote this content for you. But the thing is, like, there's nuance to everything, right? And if you're building a brand, or if you're marketing on behalf of a brand, you have to understand what that nuance is. And generally speaking, an AI tool isn't going to capture that. It can capture like the industry as a whole or the business as a whole, but in terms of like the nuance, the things that really make that brand who that brand is, AI is typically not going to get that.
There is one area that is a hot topic when talking about AI-powered tools. Do these tools replace work done by actual humans? How would this impact staffing needs at your marketing agency?
Knowing what works and what doesn't work, that's also something really important, right? So is this design, maybe it looks good from an artist's perspective or a designer's perspective, but does it work from a marketing perspective, right? Does it lead people the way it needs to? Does it push them in the right direction? So I think there always is going to be a human touch needed for that. I think another big thing to keep in mind is that humans eventually get bored by seeing the same thing over and over and again. So like, if you look at like interior decorating or design trends in the last couple of years, they're night and day different from what they were like 5 years ago. And so I think there is going to be a lot of tasks that and like positions that will be removed, but at the same time, the human touch is always going to be something necessary. So it'll be a bit of a balancing act.
The impact of these tools is yet to be discovered, and it's evolving every day. Marketing agencies will need to adapt to these new technologies fairly soon. But how do they adapt?
I think the biggest thing for anyone in marketing to recognize is what they are best at and where their time is best spent. There are so many tasks that we might enjoy doing or that we've just done for years and years and years that we just think that we need to continue to do those, when in actuality, there are systems or tools that are better suited to doing those tasks quicker. And in terms of the time value of money, it's significantly more valuable to spend money on those tools than it is for us to spend our time on those tools. I think the other part too is like ease of use and integration with your tech stack, right? If they're built into the tools you're using on a daily basis, like the other tools you're using on a daily basis, that's gonna be a lot easier for adoption. If they're standalone and you need to go out and find them, export it, whatever, build it into Facebook, that's gonna be a lot harder.
The question we all want an answer to is whether an AI can fully replace a marketer. Marketing agencies thrive on having control over the work that they do. How would this change?
A lot of our jobs are completely replaceable, you know, in the next 50 to 100 years. Hopefully machines make it to the point where we can go and just live life rather than have to work to live. You know, I don't really want to turn control over to the machines, because at some point, who's telling the machines what to do and what's best for us?
Whatever way you look at it, AI tools are here to stay. The full impact of these tools is yet to be discovered, but it is clear that there are pros and cons to them. Where does your marketing agency stand on the use of these tools?